Can you please tell us where you work at?
I work at a veterinary hospital as a veterinary technician.
All right, and so at your veterinarian hospital, do you often come across pets that you believe might come from a puppy mill?
Definitely. You can usually tell just by looking at the animal, well, when the doctor looks at them, whether or not they're from a backyard breeder or a puppy mill. They'll generally have, their genetics won't be as good. Because puppy mills and backyard breeders, they just care about making a quick profit. They want to sell the puppies as quickly as possible. They don't care about the integrity of good lines. They don't care about checking for things like hip dysplasia, other genetic abnormalities that certain breeds tend to have. They also tend to sell a lot of the designer dogs, the Puggles and Morkies and all those that are getting popular now. A lot of times they'll come in with diseases. They'll come in with Bordetella, which is kennel cough, or like upper respiratory diseases.
For a family that's trying to buy a puppy now, what would you tell them?
I would tell them if they can, they should rescue. That way you know you're not supporting a puppy mill. But if you want a purebred, a lot of people like to have a certain breed they've had for years or whatever it may be. Definitely go to a breeder, see if you can see the dogs, see the parents, see where they live. If they don't show you the dogs, something's up. If they don't want you to see anything, then you know either it's a backyard breeder or it's a large-scale operation, a puppy mill, and you don't want to be getting an animal from a place like that.
So, knowing about our birth certificate bill, how do you feel that this could possibly help by having all of the breeders now licensed?
I feel like it would definitely add more accountability to the breeders so that puppy mills would have a harder time existing and staying secretive like they are. It's really easy to produce cute, adorable puppies and seem legitimate, and not show what goes on behind the scenes. So this would kind of make people check on them and make them be more accountable for
Do
their
you think
actions.
that having the genetic information of the puppy and their parents on the birth certificate will benefit the parents?
Definitely. That way, people, when they get a dog, they can pinpoint where exactly it's from, and figure out if it's from a puppy mill or not. Whereas now, a lot of people don't know. A lot of it's kind of, like I said, kept on the down low. So this would definitely bring a lot of it to light.
Do you have a pet?
Yes, I do. I have a dog.
And do you know your dog's family's genetic background?
Not really, because it's like a mixed breed, and I just adopted it.
So you're not aware of any hereditary illnesses existing in your pet's family tree?
Not that I know of,
Are you
no.
aware that not all breeders are licensed?
Yes.
And would you prefer to know that the breeder you are buying from is licensed? And would you support a bill requiring that all breeders are to be licensed? Where and how did you get your pet?
I bought it at a place called International Kennel Club.
Now, did your pet come with papers, like a birth certificate, a warranty,
Yes.
like a document addressing past illnesses, treatments, vaccinations,
Well,
wormings?
just the shots that it already had and its family background, that it's a purebred dog.
Did you know that most pet stores purchase their puppies from puppy mills?
I've heard of puppy mills, but I didn't know that. No.
Now, are you aware of the conditions of puppy mills?
Well, on television, I remember seeing a program and they had puppy mills, and they're supposed to be horrible places where the puppies are just like kept in tight cages and not sanitary, and there's a lot of inbreeding, and I know that the conditions are bad, but I don't really know the details, but it's supposed to be very bad.